Hello and welcome back to Track 2. You're tuning in just in time to catch Team Ireland up against Team Japan. I am Julia Sleaser, joined here by the lovely Holly Sheet.
Hello there. Now we're just going to give you a quick countdown of the five skaters who are currently on the track, the team's first lineups. For Ireland, we're going to see Kian Brennan, number 051, number 27, McGrath, number 6, Heron, and number 9, McCarthy, with jamming number 042, Lieutenant Dam.
And out there for Japan, we've got 29 Bob, 3 Harakiri, 6 Chuck Breaker, 8 Naruto, and 9 Honey Badger.
And the Japan have put Harakiri on the jam line, so it's Harakiri versus Lieutenant Dan. Ireland taking that back wall. Ireland are playing in the white with the green shorts. Japan are playing in black with the gold detail. Island crew very loud, but we know Japan has always had some really good support here at these tournaments.
They certainly were a fan favorite last time.
Lieutenant Dan pushing on the sides. Japan doing a very good job of holding him back. There's a helmet cover on the floor. Is that Japan's jam helmet cover? It's
sure
gone.
Looks like it. And
Lieutenant Dan aware that he is on a roller derby athletics power jam. Straight in on jam number one.
He's got it.
And Dam jumps through, picks up a 5-point pass. Japan just distancing themselves now from the island lineup. Island dropping to the back, spreading over both sides as Dam hits that wall. It's a good clearance from the inside. That was McGrath. Dam with a lovely little jump spin. Breaks around another 5 points.
Team Ireland back in the back, knocking out entering defensive men, Chuck Breaker.
Chuck Breaker now coming through, trying to provide some offense for Harakiri.
He's having a lot of trouble getting through Ireland's defenses. Harakiri almost through on the outside, gets knocked out at the last second by number 27, McGrath.
We've had a lovely little jump there by Lieutenant Dam to pick up another 5 points. This is a good jam, starting jam here for Team Ireland. Dam again just using his teammate as a cannonball. Passes through, but we have had a break from Japan.
But as he passes down, he's going to get called off before he has a chance to score at all. So nothing picked up that time by Japan. 19 points picked up by Ireland.
We have a good start for Team Ireland. Japan just warming back into it. They have played already today. They're getting back in line with what they've been doing previously. Now, they've jumped up massively since we last saw them at the last World Cup. Certainly, their defensive system has taken a big step forwards. So let's see what these guys can show us now against Ireland. We've got number one, that is Yutu, up against number 10, that's Noblet. Noblet for Ireland out at the front, picking up Lee Jammer. You two finding that outside line, beautiful break open, and he's fast enough. Is he fast enough to get out there? Oh no! Little push there by Ali Gately.
Yeah, he may have actually been able to come in front, but better play it safe than sorry and not listen to me. So he does go back through the back. He's going to have to muscle his way back through McLaughlin et al.
Lovely jump there, and we have had a break by you two. But the inside line wide open, Noblet slides through.
Z2 comes in on his first scoring pass. Let's see what happens. He gets past his own blockers. He is past several of Ireland's blockers. He does cut the track and is being sent off. So another roller derby athletics power jam.
Ireland with now just two blockers on the track. But Noblet not needing them. He's pushing up against number 7. That's Umisan. Not able to hold him back at the front, and Noblet breaks free. That's another rank of 5 points for Team Ireland.
Right now on a 14-point jam for Ireland, they've got a significant lead just in jam two, already 33-0.
Oh, and Noblet decides to call that jam. He's just taken out the end. He was hoping for a split pack to allow him to slide past, but very well-timed drop-back bridge by Team Japan allowed them to carry on blocking, holding Ireland with just 3 points on that last jam. 36 plays four, and we've had about 4 minutes disappear in this game.
So Ab Norman now taking the line for Ireland. Japan jammer, you two frozen in the box for less than 10 seconds. He is standing.
An island drop back, waiting to see where Ab Norman hits. The inside line is cleared out, but Ab Norman takes the outside and picks up lead. Right. Beautiful jump by U2 on that inside line, and he's caught straight up and is now pushing Ab Norman. Ab Norman trying to slow him down, and Team Island trying to come up forwards and do the move known as eating the baby. I think it has happened. He's been reabsorbed back into the pack, and Ab Norman, with a big smile to the island crowd on the far side of the track, carries on his way for a scoring pass.
So what had happened at the beginning of the jam is potentially could happen again now. We've got these good defenses, a good defensive setup by Japan up front. But originally, they were concentrating on the wrong area of the track. Now, they've concentrated on the correct area. They're holding him in, and he has drawn a cut track. So it is now a Roller Derby Athletics power jam in favor of Team Japan. So U2, standing just on the edge, now has to contend against this three wall up front of Irish blockers. And as his teammates come up to meet him, that fourth Irish blocker knocking them back.
Yep, some good anti-offensive work there by Island, but it's not enough as U2 spins his way around. Big cheer from the crowd, and that's his initial pass. Some tough work there. That's a minute and 15 before he breaks free from that back.
Yeah.
Oh, lovely slide around the outside. Stays in.
That is the first, or sorry, it is 5 points picked up by Team Japan. The first 5 points in this jam. A merciless jam. Another 5 points on the board for Ireland. We are going to go the full 2 minutes, I believe.
We are indeed. Ireland now up with four on track. Japan down to just the three as Ab Norman hits. Both jammers taken down to a steady pace as Japan sends number six, which is Chuck Breaker, in to try and again break apart. And he's now pushing Ab Norman left, right and center. Ab Norman stays on track and picks up four, but it's four for Japan as well. So though that jam pretty even going, nine apiece. Hi, Mai. We've had a tweet through from Mai.
Mai says hi, Holly.
Mai from Manchester Roller Derby, who's been watching this game. Thank you very much to everybody back in the UK who is staying up and watching this game and not looking at the England game. Thank you very much. We have got an official timeout, and that gives us enough time just to throw you a read from one of our sponsors.
So, Roller Derby, or sorry, the Derby Shop Netherlands. Because Roller Derby saved your soul, but wrecks all your gear. The Derby Shop is an online as well as brick and mortar shop in Amsterdam, the Netherlands, or online at thederbyshop.nl, and is known for the best advice and technical support when it comes to all of your roller derby gear. And if you visit, bring cookies.
Obviously.
Yeah, I mean, that's a good rule of thumb.
I think they do need to have, like, currency exchange as well, but cookies in addition.
If you'll take cookies for tender, I will be buying some things. Not going to lie.
Okay, there's just a little mix around. I think we have got Righteous Oxide, who is the head referee, just escorting Team Japan around the penalty box, making sure that the jammer U2 is sat down. So that'll be a penalty from the previous jam that he's sitting for. And that's what the official timeout was, just there to clarify and clear up. And we're good to get back in. So this is going to be a Roller Derby Athletics power jam for Team Island, and they are fielding Noblitz 1-0 on the jammer line. Up on the pivot line with the blockers, Japan racing away, trying to stop Noblet from getting an easy access through, but he manages to jump through some really good breakup there by Team Island on Team Japan. In fact, they've now managed to split them in half, but Japan dropped to the back so they can reform as a trio.
So as Noblet enters, he does come up against a little bit of competition trying to get through the pack, but not for long. He takes to the outside, spins around, five more points on the board for Team Ireland, and he is coming in for his next scoring pass, just as Japan's jammer is standing in the box.
Offense being thrown in there by Raven Buster, but Noblet using his own force there. A cut being called on Mayuki Bondi allows Noblet to break free.
So you may have noticed that Team Ireland was set up in the back. It's because U2 was entering. Number 1000 has been called off McLaughlin for a multiplayer block, so it's going to make Ireland's blockers just a little bit short, which may help you to get further in this.
Oh!
He tries it on the apex and encounters
leaping contact.
Yeah, he hits Bradshaw, takes a misconduct call. It's back to Roller Derby Athletics Power Jam.
I'm getting a lot of love on Twitter. Thank you ever so much to Bon Weasley for saying hi. Hey. you can also tweet in hashtag MRDWC. Give some shout outs to my co-announcer here, Julia Sleezer. She's doing all the
Could
work.
Could you take a picture of your cat watching this game and then tweet it to Julia Sleezer?
Jam call to an end there, and Ireland managing to keep Japan down to a zero, and they will start on a Roller Derby Athletic power start with their captain 042 Lieutenant Dam on the Nerd Skate Shop Jammer line. Speaking of Nerd Skate Shops, I know they have a stall here today, but obviously if you guys are listening, you're not here. You can find them online as well.
Using the Google.
Use Google, yeah.
I feel like we've lost a page. Oh, we did. There it is. And it still doesn't have the address in.
Use that Google.
Good try.
Lieutenant Dam jumping up that inside line. He is lead jam. We've had a cut track issued out to Japan, but it's not on their jammer. And U2 manages to break free. So he's chasing Dam down. Dam is taking his time through that pack. Goes around the outside. Lovely spin. Stays on track. Gets around Chuck Breaker and calls that jam to a dead. But 2 points snuck in by U2 right at the end.
So it's a 4-2 jam. Ireland right now 66. Japan at 15, 19, 18 left in this game. Of course, if this is the first time you've tuned in, I suppose it's probably not, but we're doing half-hour bouts these first 2 days. There's only one timeout per team, and the clock will not stop running. Even if there's an injury, it's going to keep going. So it's 30 minutes. That is it.
That's it. We call it hard time. We've got Kabu Kimono on the jammer line for the first time for Japan. He's having a tough time up against Cuban Whistle Crisis, number 981, who's Roche.
Of course, that was Noblet out there for Ireland, who's now taking a seat in the box, thus inciting another Roller Derby Athletics power jam in favor of Team Japan.
It will be a short one, as I'm sure we've only just had you to Kabu Kimono sat in the penalty box for a short while. Indeed, we have now got Noblet released, and that is Alligately doing a good job at the front, but not legally. So we've got no lead jammer. This is going to be 2 minute jam. Ireland with just two blockers on the track.
Japan trying to break them up and get their jammer through. Successfully done, 4 points on the board.
Yep, Kibi Kimono doing a fantastic job indeed. The whole pack sped up, but he was so much faster. Noblet had a bit more difficulty getting through. Ireland now have three blockers on the track, and that slowed Kibi Kimono down. Oh, lots of shoulders going on. Kabu Kimono breaking free. Big cheers from the crowd, lots of them with the Japan flag, waving it in the air. In praise, he has lost his kneecap. He is putting it back on now as we speak, and that allows Noblet room at the front to break out as well. He's going to be catching Kabu Kimono up. Of course, neither of these can call this jam to an end, and it is going to run for another 10 seconds or so. Both jammers getting through. Kabu Kimono, however, being recycled back in, so this has gone in favour of Noblet on this pass. Japan dropping back, and the time runs out. So that jam has actually gone in favour of Team Ireland, who take away 12 points to Team Japan's 10 on that jam. Ireland now 78, Japan are on 25.
It's a pretty significant jam for Japan, and Dougie put it nicely when he said, why would we watch England when Japan is on?
Why indeed.
Dougie, their fan favourite.
In Japan, definitely still got their favourite levels. In fact, their shirts, I think, sold out again in the 10 minutes they were open.
Yeah. Last year, they brought very little merch, and it sold out in like 13 seconds.
Zoro,
this year, it took 10 minutes.
Zoro jamming for them. It's the first time Zoro's been jamming for Team Japan. And Ab Norman in for Team Ireland. He is not lead jammer. Zorro picking up lead jammer, but Ab Norman has already made an initial pass. Zorro, however, wants to get some points on the board. Ireland down again to just two blockers. Japan have three. And that's McGraw. Ooh. Oh, and Heron not able to hold him back. Heron now trying to go in to see if he can break Ab Norman out, but Japan doing a fantastic job. Heron tries to break that trio up. Ab Norman spins his way around, gets a little bit of a push by McGraw. And yes, they pick up 4 points there right at the end. So that's an even, 8 points to Ireland, 4 points to Japan.
This is bringing us up. Ireland 87, Japan 29. And just one flicker of us.
Just a flicker, that's all you need to see.
Teaser.
And if you're watching all the way from somewhere else and not here in Calgary, if it was too far to come, why not offer to host the 2018 Men's Roller Derby World Cup? Details are in your programs and on our website as well. And at that point, we are going to take ourselves to a quad skate shop timeout.
S1
is part of my uniform.
A clear path through the pack almost never exists. So we fight and make our own.
We are back in action.
This team timeout, just wrapping itself up. The officials have gathered in the middle, but it was just a team timeout taken there.
Got that 5 second call. Who is on the line? Number 904, Raven Buster.
Raven taken off the track, and that is Lee Jammer going to Team Japan. The crowd is just erupted there on the far side of the track.
That is Harakiri from Team Japan. Coming in fast, we've got an extraordinarily fast pack right now. Two Irish blockers trying to stop him.
Yeah, Alligator sent off. And this is going to leave Ireland depleted as they start. In fact, we're getting a misconduct. I think that's for a late hit on Roche just at the end. So that will take Ireland down to just two blockers on the track. In the next jam, Japan will have a full set of four. And on the jam line, we've got U2 for Japan against Lieutenant Dam for Team Ireland. Nice. Lieutenant Dam giving a good shunt there on U2, sending him off the track. As he's recycling back around.
Try to do one of the older moves of pulling him back to try to get him eaten into the pack or give him no choice. As the pack moves along. There we go, and no pack call allows him to step back onto the track, having not done anything with the strategy that Ireland had tried to put on him.
Dam's still going for that knock, but U2 just sliding around. He's knocked off track, but he picks up Lee Jammer as he does so. Lieutenant Dam getting a forearms penalty, sent to the penalty box. So it's now a Roller Derby Athletics power jam in favor of Team Japan's U2.
U2 having a bit of trouble getting through this pack now. Faces off against two more Irish blockers as he gets out. It's nearly to the point that it's an out of play call going to be called. But not quite. He does get through. Having been, he was declared lead and then sucked a little bit back in. So
this is still his lead, so he's now on his initial
scoring
pass.
Now he's on his first scoring pass, yeah. Calls it off. 4 points picked up by NinjaPan. So we put it 89 Ireland, 37 Japan, 11 and a half minutes left in this game.
We're going to give a shout out to the Alberta Sports Connection. The Men's Roller Derby World Cup would like to acknowledge the contributions of Alberta Sports Connection, which has helped to make this event possible. Okay, Ireland's jammer starting in the penalty box. He is standing, so this will be a 10 second or less power start roller derby athletics power jam for number two, Kabu Kimono. Oh, almost around, but just trips over, slides himself down onto the floor, and that gives Dam enough time around the outside. Lead going to Team Ireland.
So as Dan comes up on the pack, swoops through right past Japanese blockers, but he has pushed into the inside. It's going to be recycled a bit back. Oh, slamming up against Kabu Kimono as he comes through, but he is through, finished on his initial.
Yep.
So 4 points is awarded to Ireland on this last pass, and now Team Japan is coming in for the first scoring pass. Dan is going to call it off right as they reach the back of the pack, accruing no points for Japan this time. Ireland 93, Japan 37.
I'd just say there was some beautiful offensive play there by Umesan for Team Japan to break his jammer out. Unfortunately, they didn't get any points in that jam, but it's really good work. He really just wrapped himself around Team Ireland blocker. Japan have come on leaps and bounds since the last World Cup.
Definitely, definitely. They've also brought significantly more skaters this time,
as you might
remember from last time. I think they've come up with nine last time, and I think they had a full roster this time.
They have indeed.
So that is number three out there for Japan, Harakiri.
He's up against Abnorman, 045 for Team Ireland. Abnorman stuck on that inside line. He's not wanting to come too far out as Ireland are still trying to block Harakiri, but Harakiri pushes his way through, G-ing up the crowd as he goes by. He needs to be careful though, because that helmet could
up. Oh, come on now.
I thought it was his helmet cover would come off, but his balance went instead.
It's slippery.
Oh, what a shame. He has picked up 2 points, however, and I'm sure he's picked up a lot of supporters on that jam as well.
So for those of you, again, thank you for tuning into this track. The unofficial score from track one was England won by a lot.
A lot.
A lot.
It's a technical term.
Yeah.
Beautiful replay that we're seeing here. Oh, just clipped out. Just Abnorman dodging his way around the Team Japan blockers. And we are going to go to a team timeout to Japan. So this is...
We're going to be testing three helmets today. This simulates a 10 mile an hour impact or a 4 foot drop. The S1 Lifer helmet with EPS fusion foam did pass the multiple impact test.
I've seen you before. Isn't that weird? It's nice. And we are back on. So, you two is going to be taking the line, and he's going to be against Noble. Here in a few seconds when we get back underway. I don't mean to taunt you. It is coming. See? Swoopy whistle means we're back.
We're gonna get
30
going.
Seconds out. Short time.
Yeah, both jammers having done some high rotation for both of their teams. Oh, and that is a quick star pass over to number four, Mayugi Bondai for Japan.
He's not quite got it on, but he's hot on the heels of Noblet. Noblet is well aware. Having lead jammer status, he's going into the pack, and we'll see what he does with it, because his skaters are right at the back with just one of Japan's blockers. He calls it off. I suspect that's a 1 point, and I'm right. So Team Ireland picking up one. Japan not capable of getting any of that time.
Some really clever, well-timed call-off there by Team Ireland.
So once again, Lieutenant Dam out there, going to be facing off against Harakiri. We have an empty penalty box.
Say what?
Yeah, 5 and 5. We need somebody to sponsor the empty penalty box. And then somebody else to sponsor the one that has anybody in it.
I wouldn't want to sponsor the empty one. Might not get that many times it's called out.
Yeah, it feels like it. I'd mention it every once in a while. Lieutenant Dam has gotten lead jammer status for Team Ireland, but back behind about a quarter away. Back is Harakiri from Japan.
Oh, little apex jump by Harakiri, but it was well after those whistles. Dam knocked to the outside line, called that jam as well. So a 0-0 jam. I never like to think of them pointless because they're always worth something. even if it's just experience. But no points back on the board, so we are 94-39 with just over 6 minutes left in this game.
Pretty high score differential at this point. Team Japan fielding U2 and Team Ireland, Raven Buster. Still got that empty penalty box, got the 5-on-5 out there. The pack is quite thick to start.
Oh, and U2 picking up a multiplayer penalty. He was actually acting as fifth blocker there, so picking up that penalty gives us a roller derby athletics power jam for Ireland. Raven Buster trying to slide through, takes the Japan blocker to the outside and is broken out by Ali Gately.
Both teams forming sort of a three-wall with that extra blocker in rotation, ready to knock out anybody trying to bust up their wall. Raven Buster does bust through Japan's wall, getting 5 more points for Team Ireland. This power jam is finished. U2 is back in play.
Beautiful toe-stop work by U2 to stay on track. He's still taking a few hits, but manages to break at the front. A steady call off there by Raven Buster, Team Ireland. Quite happy with the 4 points he picked up.
So that brings Ireland up to 108, Japan at 39. They are going to be feeling Ab Norman for Ireland. And Kabukimono. For Japan.
A big hi to Velocity on Twitter. Thank you so much for sending your tweets in. If you are sending more tweets, please do hashtag MRDWC. And we've got a race round now with the jammers, Ab Norman. Having a look behind him, I don't think we got any points by either. Oh no, we have a sneaky 2 points there by Ireland. And holding Japan to a zero. So Kabukimono unable to get anything out of that last jump.
Yeah, there was actually a star pass to Naruto.
Oh, was it?
Yeah, I was like, wait, so did we misread that?
Yeah.
No, I just saw him take it off and he had the pivot underneath. So there was a super sly.
Japan
star pass.
Did put in a sneaky one earlier, straight off of that jammer line, so I think Ireland need to keep an eye out for that. Harakiri having a little bit of difficulty here, he's knocked off that outside, but finds the inside, just gives a little nudge and breaks his way through, but Nobler is lead jammer. Oh, a little bit of athletics there by Mayugi Bondi, but he's not able to catch Noblet on his way around. Ireland really trying their best to slow down Harakiri. He comes up against McLaughlin and is taken down, but he's bounced back up. And in the meantime, Noblet has also worked his way through. It's 4 points for both jammers so far on that pass.
Zero of Hyrule reports that Roach one time knocked him unconscious and that it was awesome, or so people have told him. I would not be interested in any such thing, no matter how awesome it looked. I guess you have a good story though, right?
Well, if you can send it through to us on Twitter, please do. Any interesting stories for this team or any of the other teams who are playing here this weekend, hashtag MRDWC.
Going to have Zoro out on the line up against Lieutenant Dam. The Lieutenant, of course, been a favorite in this jammer rotation. He knocks Zoro out to the outside. Zoro comes back in. Lieutenant Dam is going to get himself a forearm penalty, bringing about another roller derby athletics power jam in favor of Team Japan. Oh,
except,
sorry, it was a track cut.
No, he has indeed. He's got a penalty for elbows, but we have had another penalty, a cutting penalty towards Team Japan, and that is...
Zoro
in the penalty box for that cut. So a quick release on Lieutenant Dam, but Zoro now also making his way back on.
That also means, since both teams are out of their timeouts, this is going to go the full 2 minutes, and this is going to be the last jam. Lieutenant Dam is headed back to the box for a track cut. So Zoro is out on his initial and ready to re-enter for his scoring pass.
Oh, beautiful. little fake to the outside there. Team Japan just clearing the way for Zoro to make his way through. They have picked up a penalty, but I think they'll be quite happy if they're picking up points as well. Inside line cleared. Island caught napping there. We've now got Lieutenant Dan returned back to the track. He's completed his initial pass, so he's now in his scoring position as well.
Zoro taking a little bit of a tumble. Like, Ireland's defenses are really heavy at this moment.
It's so heavy. They've got five blockers currently working as Dam is bracing his own team.
Dam comes through, taking up those 4 points. Zoro gets knocked into the inside. He's going to have to come back through the back. And that is the end of that jam. Just a few seconds left as the period clock goes down. Since there are no timeouts left, I suppose we'll just live through them.
I think so, yeah.
If
we hand fire,
there we go.
See what happens.
So the unofficial final, Team Ireland 126, Team Japan 55. I hope you've enjoyed watching this game as much as I have.
I've certainly enjoyed watching it. We do see Ireland come up again at 7 o'clock local time. They're playing Scotland over on track number 1. And Japan are playing later again on track number 1 at 8 o'clock local time. And they'll be playing Team USA.
For the record, local time is mountain time. So if you are in the UK, as I suspect many of you are, saying hi to Holly and all, that would be GMT +7, yes. So, math accordingly. Hope you can make it in. The official final is now Ireland 126, Japan 56, and thank you so much for joining us.
Miss the feeling of spontaneously visiting a store and trying out the newest gear. Hang out for all roller skaters. Everyone has their own unique style. Because of our large assortment, we can now personalise roller skates while you wait, so you can try them out right away. Our mission is to fit you with the right gear, and don't forget to turn left.
My boat.